It's spring, and that means weddings. And if you're planning an engagement or you are engaged, you're probably really excited. You may even be feeling a little anxious about the flowers, the venues, the cake. But is the marriage the person that you're going to share your life with forever? Are they the right person? Today on Reaction Reset, we're talking about the qualities every marriage should have before you get married. There's a myth that couples walking down the aisle may carry, and that myth is, after you get married, you can change your partner to be more like the person you really want them to be. This is not only a myth, but it's destructive. It can end up ruining your marriage because you cannot change someone after you get married. You have to work with them before you get married, and people naturally will change on their own depending upon what they value most. It's more likely that the problems that you sweep under the rug or don't confront will come up later and cause bigger issues in your marriage. Every marriage has problems. There's no perfect marriage, and that's normal. But if your marriage lacks the qualities that I'm going to go through in just a bit, it's highly likely that you won't be successfully or healthily married. If you notice any of these things that I go through, talk with your partner, your fiance, prior to walking down the aisle. The first one is no surprise. It's commitment. When you are able to commit, it means you're emotionally mature enough. You understand that you're going to have to make sacrifices, that there's going to be things you want to do that are not good for the marriage or don't make your partner happy. Until you get a sense that this person with you is committed to the marriage, that they don't see a divorce as an option or a way out, the better and more successful your marriage is going to be. The second one is shared values. Couples who share the same values align together. Feeling as though your partner values what you value, it makes it easier to create a vision for your marriage, which is so important. You can actually take it step by step. This is our vision for this year. This is for 5 years. Now this is our 10-year vision, and it keeps your marriage united and close. The third one, and really important, especially what I see in my therapy sessions, is friendship. Is this person your friend? Remember, a friend is someone that you stand by no matter what. When they're having a bad day, you don't go through all the other mistakes they made. Or when they tell you something, you take it seriously. When you hurt them, you apologize. A friendship is built on a mutual trust and a mutual respect and a mutual love and concern that you want what is in this person's best interest. Not only that, friendship keeps the spark in the marriage. It keeps it fun. The next one, and most major, is the ability to communicate. Good communication is something that has many parts to it. When you can communicate with someone, it doesn't mean you're just gonna agree. You know how when you're in that beginning relationship stage, you kind of agree with everybody because you don't really know who they are and you don't want to upset them? When you can truly communicate with someone, you can say what you want to say, you don't feel judged, you don't feel shamed, nobody's trying to talk you out of how you feel. They may try to show you another perspective. They may be able to say, well, I respect that, but that's not what I believe. They don't need you to agree with them. And not only that, when you can communicate well, you feel safe. The last one is twofold, honesty and trust. So the thing about trust, let's talk about that first. when you have true trust for this person, you don't need to monitor their cell phone. You don't need to look at their passwords. I still think it's a good idea to share passwords, but you don't want to get on this stuff. You're not checking them. You trust them. If you notice that your partner is really jealous, or they don't like, they're checking up on you, or they don't like it when you go out with certain friends, that's a red flag, and you better resolve that issue prior to getting married. Don't think trust issues are going to go away. The second part of the trust issue is honesty. When you're honest, it means that you are transparent with your life. If someone says, I want to see your phone or I want to use your phone, you give it to them. Do you know why? Because you have nothing to hide. People who are honest, are with each other especially, are living a life where they have already decided that they can be vulnerable with this person. If any of these things I've mentioned have you thinking, I'm just not sure, we fight about that, or we seem to come to a standstill, invest in pre-marriage counseling. It will be the best investment you ever make. Don't walk down the aisle knowing you have these things that are going wrong or not resolved, thinking after you're together for a while, you'll be able to work it out. It doesn't work out like that, guys. In fact, it usually turns out that those marriages limp along and oftentimes are the very ones that split 5, 10, 15 years down the road. And this is exactly what we don't want to happen. So just as an added pearl, I'm going to give you guys three things that I see in my counseling practice that I find are the biggest issues and the most likely not to be resolved prior to marriage. So if you have any of these, then I strongly encourage you, and if I knew you personally, I would say go to marriage counseling. The first one is if one of your partners, either one of you has an attachment to an ex. They've not been able to resolve that. Do not walk down that aisle with that person. If one of the people of the couple has an addiction, if there is an addiction and it has not been talked about, it has not been resolved, or the partner says, I have resolved it and I'm done. Most addictions I know need continued care. Why? Because they're recovering. And when you have an addiction, it never fully goes away. You enter a stage of recovery forever. That must be talked about. And the last one is any communication problem, honesty or transparency or trust. Those three will bring resentment and hardship to any marriage. And so make sure that you guys sit down, be open and honest about it. The worst thing you're thinking is, I don't want to go to counseling. It's one more thing I have to put in there. Not true. Counseling will actually open up your perspective. It will make you feel so much more secure, and you'll leave feeling so united, like we are creating this marriage, and that's a great thing. Frank Pittman was the grandfather of all marriage counseling, and he said the wisest words I ever heard: when you get married, it's like getting into a submarine. Don't go down, or in this case, don't walk down the aisle till you fully close the hatch and you are going to work this out together. And with that, I am going to say, change your reaction, change your world.